everyone's attention, please. We get going here. Reverend Fathers, ladies and gentlemen. Celebrate 50 continuous years of the club. So we're going to get going here right away.
Yes, thank you all for coming. And we'll get
Pierre Fox up here to sing the national anthem here. Started in 69 and who are still involved with the club today. One of them today is our current secretary, the other, that's Sean Clark, our current secretary, and Colin Devlin, our vice president. So I'm going to invite the two of them here to cut a cake here celebrating the 50 years. So it's been Sean Clark and Colin Devlin. Anybody would like to take a photograph? Okay, folks, that's that job done now, and we'll just get Father Gallagher here is now going to say a grace before meals, maybe a few words as well, and then we'll get into the food.
Just remain seated for this, a few words to share before we bless the food and bless our occasion this evening. It's good that you get the tackles in early, so I'm in first. Good evening, everyone, and Fáilte Róid to this gala dinner in the Silver Birches here in Annomy. I thank the committee for inviting me to share the grace before meals with you, but first a few words as we reflect and ask Bannacht Jay on this night. It's a special night, an Éire Mór, in the life of our club, in our parish, and for all that are part and parcel of this club, from within and without the parish boundaries, for there is no such thing as a hard border in our part of the world. Only a soft, open border to facilitate the playing of all the games of Common Good Class Day. Tonight, as we begin our Golden Jubilee 50th anniversary gala celebration and ask God to bless this night, we're thankful. Thankful for all who've contributed and continue to contribute to our club in so many ways, who give so much of themselves that allow our young people to blossom and to share their gifts and talents for the enjoyment of others and for their own physical and mental well-being. On behalf of all who've ministered in the parish before me over these 50 years, whether living or deceased or even sitting beside me, thank you for your contribution to the life and well-being of the parish of Greencastle and beyond. We're conscious too of those who made this possible and who are no longer with us. It was right and proper that we should remember them and pray for them as we did at our annual Memorial Mass on Wednesday evening in preparation for tonight. We're particularly conscious of our friend, founding member, player, past chairman, Father O'Thrassy, P.D. Tracy, who we lost so unexpectedly last May, or Yeshje Goro Anan Jilish. And we commend to God all who have gone before us, contributed in any way to Uncashling Glasney of Padraig over the past 50 years. So finally, it's a privilege and a pleasure to be here with you tonight on this special occasion, and thank you also for sending in reinforcements in the persons of my fellow dairyman, Tony Scullion, and Father Eugene Hassan. Now, yes, Mr. McGinn, you're giving me a look. Now, let us bless the food and enjoy. In anam an ahar, agus an vic, agus an spirit naiv, amen. Banishin a hirna, agus na brontin a shaw uit, a wolimage of a glacu, o de rach, tri Christ, gierna, amen. Nana Manahar, Augustin Vic, Augustin Spirit, and Eve Amen. Go to my heart.
Now we can get on with the food. Carry on with the rest of the night. Thank you. Okay, folks, so I'm going to introduce you here to a couple of men who both can relate quite well to Greencastle. We have Noel McGinn here, obviously, who was a headmaster here for over 20 years in our primary school, and who's seen probably a lot of the characters here tonight, and a lot of the guys who's playing in teams, the later years teams anyway, are toddling, and then maybe the earlier days, Tony was involved with some of the boys managing and playing with some of the boys. Both of them can, I'm sure, tell a few stories, but we'll let Noel here. Noel's going to lead out the events here, and we'll take it from there. Thank you. Thank you.
The way that we've agreed this is that we'll do the presentations first, and then Tony will say a few words, and I'll follow that. Could I just say before we start the presentations that tonight at the table down below we were at there, it was an education for myself and for Tony because Mav was sitting down between us. And we were just walking up the floor and Tony says, Mav is the greatest footballer I've ever heard. So I don't necessarily agree with that. I saw him playing and he was almost as good as he thought he was. But anyway, good to have him at the table, and then, you know, I felt like Christ between two thieves tonight. Two dairymen on my right, one who openly admitted having spent 40 years in Tyrone, now feels more like a Tyrone man, which is Father Hassan, thank God. And then I had Father Gallagher and Tony Scullion on my left. I think it's the first time I've ever been between two dairymen that I didn't end up black and blue. But when you hear Tony talking after, I would say it'd be a wonderful dinner date because he's a passionate man around the table. He really is, and it took us a long time to eat the dinner because we were swapping stories, and I told him, I said, don't look now over your shoulder, there's six all iron medals there. This is Philip Jordan sitting there and Hub Hughes. So could you put your hands together for two fantastic outstanding players. And Tony, being the shy dairyman, says, you know, I'm going to ask him for their autographs, you know. I says, you can ask Jordan, but he'll charge you for saying this. Only joking, Philip, only joking. Anyway, sorry, enough of that. We're going to get on here with the presentations first of all. I'll call out the names of the recipients. Come up here, and the recipient will shake the hand with a legend in Gaelic football, Mr. Tony Scullion, All-Ireland champion, 3 times National League winner, and just a real, real good fella. So remember that when you're shaking hands, you are shaking hands with a legend. So, first of all, we have the Handball Person of the Year, and that award goes to Kieran Tracy. Good man, Kieran. Score Performer of the Year. Good man, Kieran, well done. No surprise, this award goes to the one and only Kira Fox. Kira told me not that long ago that I was a big influence on her musical choices. She says anything that I ever sang, she decided never a chance would she sing it. Well done, Kira. Camogie Player of the Year, this award goes to Carla McCann. This is a joint award, and it goes to Niamh O'Neill and Shanley Clark. Mary Tracy. Mary Tracy will present this award, so Mary, if Mary's there, Mary Tracy to present this award, please. Oh, presented by Claire, sorry, Claire. Well done, Gerrits. Yeah, that's it. Hold those up. Well done, Shanley. Well done, Lee. Good stuff. Under 21 Player of the Year, Frank Ward will present this one, please. Frank should be there if you want to head up. And this award goes to Kieran Coy. Come on, Kieran. Well done, Frank. Thank you very, very much. Reserve Player of the Year. And this one goes to, and Tony's going to present this one, Dara McDermott. Come on, Dara. Mickey John McDermott, come up to you. Mickey John's going to present the Senior Player of the Year as well, please. And Kevin McCullough, if you're there, can you come up also? Well done, Dara. Reserve Player of the Year, 2019, Dara McDermott. Senior Player of the Year, this presentation will be done by Mickey John McDermott. And this award goes to, delighted to say this, Ryan Gunn. Popular winner. And I have to say, if ever you wanted to demonstrate the old saying about the fight and the dog or the dog and the fight, and the size of the fight of this week out here, himself and Ronan Hollywood a number of years ago, when they were playing for the Premier School team, dragged us out of many, many holes and won us many, many matches in several competitions. And he's going to be a super, super player. Welcome, Ryan. Good lad. And the club person of the year, and this will be presented by Kevin McCullough, the PGA McCullough Trophy. And this is jointly won by Michael Coyle and Helen Clark. Stanley Clark, if you would just come up on behalf of Helen to accept this trophy. Stanley, thank you. The next set of awards are a special set of awards to those who were involved in the club committee back in 1969. And I'll touch on this a wee bit later. But these awards will be presented by Tony. And first of all, this one, we'll just call out the names, and then on some occasions there's some, there'll be someone else to receive it. But receiving on behalf of John Bradley, Frankie Bradley, please. On behalf of John Bradley. Good man, Frank. Well done, sir. Good stuff. And may Tracy to collect on behalf of Peter Tracy. Put your hands together, please. Thank you. Thank you, Mary. Thank you, Mary. Well done. Now, this time, this award is for Brendan Morris, and I'm going to ask Emma Bradley to collect it on behalf of Brendan Morris. I was telling Emma earlier there, I said to him, very clean shaven and well dressed tonight. He says he got a Turkish massage. I said, what? He meant he got a Turkish shave, he was a bit confused. You alright there, boss? Okay. Next up, same man, this award is for Kevin Morris, and Emma Bradley is collecting it again. Thank you, Emma. Good man, well done. Thank you, Emma. Please welcome Sean Clark. Good man, Sean. Good man, Sean. Well done. One of the first men I ever became acquainted with from Greencastle, because he drove a lorry for Bradley and Michael Hatton. And he also turned out to be a referee and took my name on many occasions. The one and only Mr. PJ McDermott. Come on, PJ. Pedro comes to the podium here. Could I welcome also this time Raymond McDermott, please? And Raymond is going to collect the award on behalf of Brian McDermott. So Raymond, please, if you come to the side. Well done. Come on, Pedro, well done. Raymond McDermott is collecting on behalf of Brian. Come on, Raymond. This one, well done, good man. For Paddy McDermott, and I'm asking Mickey John McDermott, please, to come to the front to collect that award. For Paddy McDermott. Mickey John, please. the man with the jump by you. Another member of that 1969 club committee, Mickey Bradley, and I'm going to ask Keir Fox to collect the award on his behalf. Keir Fox to collect on behalf of Mickey Bradley. Thank you, Keir. Sean Teague will collect this time, and it's on behalf of Peter J. Keenan. Sean Teague, please. Come on, Sean. And as usual, there's usually clergy involved in these things, so we're going to ask Father Gallagher to collect this one on behalf of Father McFaul. So, Father Gallagher. Please don't trip the dairy man as he comes towards the stage. Thank you, Father. And Father Hassan, please, to collect on behalf of Father McLaughlin. Father Hassan, please. This one, the two priests, both dairy men, tell you a sweet story. There was a priest in Balahai a number of years ago, and it was way back, like the time of the conflict, you know, and he ran into and knocked down a pig on the side of the road one night. So he phoned the local REC station, and the sergeant answered, and the sergeant was a well-known, didn't like priest. And he says, yes, he says, it's Father Henry here. Yes, he says. And he says, I knocked down a pig on the side of the road. And the cop says to him, did you not give it the last rites? He says, I thought I'd notify the next of kin first. Anyway. Father Hassan told me that one earlier. First green cast and team of 1970. I was reminding Mickey John there just when we were sitting at dinner that I made my debut against Greencastle back in 1977, junior championship final. I was 15 years of age at the time and did goals, and we won 15 points to 3. And the full-back hit the kick-outs back in those days. I actually spent the entire game never in touch of the ball. But Mickey John maintained if he'd been playing full forward instead of mile, it would be a different kettle of fish. We'll hear about that later. The 1970 team, please welcome to the front here. First of all, Frank Ward. Come on, Frank. There's always one, Frank, isn't there? Good man, Frank. Please welcome Michaela Fox to collect on behalf of Brendan Morris. Thank you, Michaela. Please welcome on behalf of Jim McCrory, Karen O'Neill. Thank you, Karen. Please welcome, on behalf of Paddy McDermott, Mickey John McDermott, please. Mickey John. Yeah. And while Mickey John's coming up there, please, would you also welcome PJ McDermott, please, to the front. PJ McDermott. And while PJ's coming there, please welcome also to the stage, or to the front, on behalf of Frank Tracy, Barry Tracy. Dominic McCullough and his award will be picked up by Kira Fox. Thank you, Kira. Award for Francis Keenan, and I'll ask Sean O'Neill to come up to collect that award for Francis. Sean O'Neill. Sean, as we get our way forward. Paddy McKenna, and that award will be picked up by Jean McKenna. Thank you, Jean. So Paddy McKenna's award will be picked up by Jean McKenna. And Mickey Higgins' award was picked up by Breach Brogan. Thank you, Breach. Go ahead. And while Breach is making her way forward, an award for Eamon Potter, and that award was picked up by Rory Conway. Thank you, Rory. Go ahead. This award goes to a man who I've known myself for years and years, and this one goes to the one and only Colm Devlin. Thank you, Colm. The award for Peter Tracy will be picked up again by Mary Tracy. Mary, you're very, very welcome. And while Mary is making her way forward, the next award goes to Peter McDermott, and this one has been presented by Michaela, or picked up, I beg your pardon, by Michaela McDermott. Michaela McDermott. Michaela, thank you. Please welcome the next award winner, Sean Clark. Thank you, Sean. Good man. Sean makes his way forward. The final award in terms of the 1970 team, and this one will be received by Frankie Bradley on behalf for Anthony Keenan. Frankie Bradley, please pick up on behalf of Anthony Keenan. Thanks, Frank. Now, when Frankie's coming up, I'm just going to call out the Reserve Championship winners of 2019. And as I call out, come on ahead up and receive your medal. Do you want a team photograph at the end?
Yes!
Okay. Team photograph at the end will be taken out of the car park. Right, please welcome to the front, Dara McDermott. Michal McCann, I think Sean Rowe's going to collect for Michal. Come on ahead, what's your name? Come on ahead. Kieran Coyle. Seamus Warnock. Jerry McNamee isn't here, but Darrell's collecting on his behalf. Come on ahead. As we can fill in that order, you know yourselves the order of the names come out in there. Kieran McNamee, and Darrell's going to collect that one to see. Number 6, Mark McNulty. Yeah.
Come on, Mark. Well done. Shane McCullough. Come on, Shane. Caelan McAleer. Jernan Teague. Sean Oakes there, isn't he? Okay. Patrick Michael Hatton. Come on, Patrick. Back to that. Sean Keneally. Dean Fox. Connor McGarvey. Gavin Slane, and Darrell's going to collect that one. Fergal McCrory. Plunkett 2. I don't think you're aware, Plunkett is part of the Masters team. He has been playing underage for the last 2 years. Conan McGuire. Arne Donnelly. I hope you're coming. Is Arne Donnelly... Is it all the way to the toilet? Yeah. I have to say, when Arne was at school, he was exactly the same. Once something important had to be sorted, Arne was in the bathroom. Which is most. It's understandable. Sean McBride is not here, Darrell will collect. Brian Devon. Come on, Brian. And while Brian is making his way here, please also welcome to the stage Shay Michael Hatton. Come on, boys. Barry McNulty. Come on, Barry. Jordan Gumley. And if Jordan's not there, Ryan can collect, but if Jordan's there, perfect. Ryan's can collect. Eamon Tracy and Darrell will collect that one. Colin Tracy, team captain. Come on, Ryan. Come on, Colin. Daniel McCrory. Come on, Daniel. Well, Daniel's making his way forward. Also, please welcome Emmett Bradley. The last man I saw walk like that. Hold on. Was Boris Johnson at the DUP convention, but we all know what happened to him. Emmett McAleer and Darrell will collect that one. Francis Michael McKenna and Gene will collect that one. Gene, yeah.
And we could just say, whoever did the table plan tonight was brilliant. When you put all the recipients in the very, very back, and it's a fair long walk to come the whole length of that floor. Right or wrong, Gene? It'd be like one of those John Brennan training sessions. And the last but not least, please put your hands together, Darren McCullough. Now we're going to get them together and get a team photograph for us, okay? Right, you tell us where. And then we have two more presentations to make, and then Tony's going to say a few words. Right. They're here now if you can, all right? The big ugly ones get in the back, and then the other ones in the front. Hands together, please, fellas. There, team folks. Very, very well done. Well done indeed. And long standing service award. And this goes to two men who will be forever, as always, associated with Queen Classic Club. Welcome both of them to the stage. Put your hands together, please, for Colin Devlin and for Sean Clark. And Sean's going to say a few words. We've got one ahead, Colin. Right, folks, that completes the presentations. I'm again down. Folks, just when we're sitting here, I'm sure, like me, you really enjoyed that meal and the service was first class. So put your hands together, please, for the staff here. They've done a brilliant, brilliant job. Well, well done to the staff of the Silver Birch Hotel. We're going to hand the mic over to Sean. Sean, come on out. You want to stand for you, Colin? But the night the Senate, since this is certainly about 5 minutes ago, the night the Senate, it's time to think back to where we did start. And I suppose it's fantastic to see the change from 1969 to now in our part of the world. In 1969, when we set out to set up a club, really it was a simple enough operation because we had a number of people who were interested in playing. It wasn't a costly exercise. There was very little involved in it. But I did the job in getting our people together. And the big success is that we've got from there to here and to the position that we're in today. As time went on, we got round till
looking about ground for ourselves and eventually buying the ground and eventually building on it and building and even building this year, you know, so that sort of work has been going on. But in the meantime, we spread out over the years. It went from just a basically a senior team to underage teams to camogie to ladies football, to taking part in all the cultural activities. So, and looking at that timeline that was from the beginning, it's actually hard to believe that so much activity has happened and has been happening. But it has. And the community is now very proud of itself. And I believe one of the main reasons is because of the club. It gives the community a focal point. It gives an opportunity for all ages, everybody can be involved or can get a pastime or can get entertainment or whatever through that club. So I think that's the big thing that we've done. But as well as that, during that time, there's been an awful lot of success to individual to teams and to individuals. And we must congratulate all those people who have put in the effort to get that success, to deliver on that success. And like, I think we're one of only very few clubs in Ireland that has managed to win an All-Ireland at club level at both men's and ladies. So I'll not go any farther other than to say that we have to be proud of what we've achieved, we have to be proud of our people, and we have to be proud of the contribution that so many people made in so many ways. Any time that support was needed in the area, raising a bit of money or whatever it was, the help was there and the contributions were there. So we had, even though we mightn't have a big population, we have a great commitment from the community. And not naming names, but I would like to think that we should remember all those people who have gone before us, who have given their bit, who have, some people have passed away in early years when they didn't reach the full maturity at all, right through to the likes of a man who would have been delighted to be here the night, Peter Tracy, who died in the earlier part of the year. And I would like to also thank all the people who, you know, made available the ground and was facilitated this when we were purchasing the ground for our pitches. For all the local people who put in an awful lot of effort in many ways to put on the physically what they are, what they are, like by way of labour, financial contribution, what do we say, brains behind the scenes. Everything that made us what we are. So I'll leave it on that. I think we're the club is in a fantastic position today, and hopefully in the years to come it'll just get stronger. So thanks very much.
Okay, and super words. We're now going to hand over to without doubt one of the finest fullbacks, or members of any fullback line that I ever saw and ever had the pleasure of sitting beside. One and only Tony Scudgeon. Please welcome Tony to the podium.
Father Geller, Father Hassan, ladies and gentlemen, what can I say? I'd have to say, maybe other than one wee blip the night. Ah, well, maybe it was longer than a wee minute, whatever. But from the first time I stepped through the door of the night, when I met Darrell McCullough and his wife, till now, Where else in the world could we be in better company than among GAA people? Daryl phoned me, maybe it must have been the start of the year about this night, and it's a pleasure and an honour. But as I said to you, the only downside of the night, and I don't know if it's Daryl's fault, but I don't know how I ended up on the table I ended up with. Oh, no, no, the two holy men down there, great, no bother. But the man, to my right, was bad enough. He has every rib knocked out of my body. But he's the man to my left. What do you call him? Val or Mal or what? And all I listened to the whole night, and I was sure, I'd be shaking his hand every 10 seconds or 5 seconds up here. Because he's told me he's the best player in Greencastle. The best player in Tyrone, is he? Tell me, is he? He is me second. By the way, all seriousness, we're sure we're our neighbours, Derry and Tyrone, Ballinascreen and Greencastle. Hey, don't be. Sean or Colm, two legends. But I don't want them to answer this question, because nothing has been kept in record. And if Daryl doesn't have it in record, it's not in record. But we beat Tyrone in 1988 in the opening of that pitch in Greencastle. So remember that. That was a Derry one that day. I had a number of bad days at Tyrone. And again, the man to my right tonight, as well as knocking the bloody ribs out of me, he kept talking about 1986, the great goal he scored against Derry and Omagh in the championship, the 2-6-1-7 scoreline, Noel McGinn, up in the back of the net. And then, of course, another bad day. We've had a number of bad days, and we've had a number of bad days in recent times, but 95 wasn't a great day either. But, saying that, as Noel has already acknowledged, there's two great throne men down there, and Philip Jordan and Kevin Hughes, and fair play to you men. I'm not going to skunk you too long, because I know that you will be wanting to get on the move shortly. And I watched that great video, and it was brilliant, and all the thanks and all the deserving congratulations has been done. But coming from my own club in Ballinascreen, that we cater for the majority of GAA sports, to your club in a rural part of Ireland, and what you do for your community, and I'll mention the two men again who was there at the beginning, Sean and Colm, right through to 2019, what you've done for your community, the people of Greencastle, the people that lines the fields, the people that cuts the grass, the people that does all the ladies, all the men, who makes the sandwiches, who makes the tea, who does up their club rooms. And I was up there in the summertime, visiting a cool camp in Greencastle, and I'll be honest with you, I could not believe, from the last time I was in your club to this summer, the place is mighty. Do you realise what you have done, what you have put in your lands in Greencastle as a credit to you? Absolute credit. And as I said, the codes, And I'm not going to, as I say, it's already been done. The camogie. You keep battling. You keep battling. You keep battling. You'll come back. You're back. You are back. You'll never go away. Fair play to you. You have the handball. The handball alley, the handballers will never go away. They're there. And all thank and well done to the success, camogie, and the young handballers. You have the ladies footballers. You have the ladies footballers who brought home the All-Ireland in 2011, am I right in saying? And who's been winning championship and championship. Fair pity, ladies footballers. You have the score. That's what the GA is about. You're representing the score heavily. As I said, Darren McCullough sent me through a wee bit of history about Greencastle last week, and I got a wee look at it today. And also the score was represented big time. And there was a name mentioned in the score. And I started to, because her name was mentioned a few times, so I was sitting at a laptop. I'm not the greatest person on the laptop. But as I say, I entered her name. And all of a sudden in front of me was Kira Fox singing. What a marvellous, marvellous voice. I'm going to say to Kieran the rest of you tonight, me and my wife Siobhan would like going to concerts. And we have a very favourite singer around this country, Donna Taggart. But I'll tell you, Kira, you'll stand shoulder to shoulder with her anyway. And Kira, may I say one thing. I have three young ones, and please God, the man above, but all I'm saying is, hopefully in happy times, hopefully it's not in sad times, maybe you'll end up in Ballinscreen some evening or some morning or something like that. Then we have, we're not mentioned yet. We mentioned the Camogues. We haven't mentioned the footballers yet, none of them must. What? The handball, the camogie, the ladies football, the score, no, a score, which is brilliant, absolutely. And the success of the people in the score. And the young ones and all, I couldn't believe it as they were dared with the information I got and the wee history. The success within the score, within this club, has been brilliant. And then, of course, the men's football. And the fourth thing I must say, to the champions, to our own reserve champions this year, fair play to you, Greencastle. Well, again, looking at the video tonight, the success that the senior footballers have had from a rural part of Ireland. Absolute credit. I remember being up in your hall in the start of 2007, I'm right to say. And Barry McAlduff, Mickey Hart, Noel McGinn, Paddy Hunter was there, if I can mind right. And there was a wee chat show that night in your hall. And the place was bombed. She was raising the rafters. And I'll be honest with you, that was the best night's crack. That was the best. And you know, this was up the road from Ballinasteen. And I was saying about thinking to myself what was going to be on the night. I was going to be asking whether it was a wee Ballinasteen man coming up to that. And I was delighted, of course, but see when I was on down the road again. Why is this being classical one of there? I just got the buzz from the people within the place. And you know this, I'll tell you a wee thing, Greencastle. Do you just realise what you've done that time? Do you just realise you've won in Ireland? Do you realise in the preceding 12 years since you won it in 2007? The preceding 12 years, Kerry clubs, different Kerry clubs, have won 7 All-Irelands. I think it was 7 out of 12 Kerry clubs won. And this is what I, even though I work for the GA, and maybe I'm speaking in turn, but I'm a man of speaking my mind. But I cannot understand the hierarchy of the GA, how senior clubs in Kerry can play in a junior championship. It's an absolute disgrace. You play senior football and you finish up in the junior championship. But you boys went down there and beat them. The only Ulster club, not our own Tyrone club. The only Ulster club to win the All-Ireland Junior. Yes, somebody might put up a hand with somebody from Cavan here. But unofficially, a Cavan club won it in 2002. But as far as I know, the real junior All-Ireland Junior competition didn't start in 2004. So Greencastle is the only team that's ever won an All-Ireland Junior title. Right, that's me. Hey, right, great night. Again, as I said to you, I was coming in the night. And Edgar and what, that man's, along with another few, has done an enormous amount of work. But then I went on and I met another man. And he's sitting over to me right. Sean Tate. If I was going into a trench tomorrow morning, I'd like him at my right shoulder. He'd be my type of boy. Great, great man. A man, and yes, and I'm going to miss somebody within him tonight, and I'm sorry, but a man who captained this county and won the Anglesell Cup. A proud Greencastle man. Great, great man, and I hope the young ones within the audience tonight, you realise the young ones that's still able to tie the boots, which is the best days in your life, young ones, and you're looking up at me tonight, and you may be looking at Sean sometime, and he wore that t-shirt, and I tried the best to wear it too. But I'll tell you this, they are the best days of your life, young boys and young girls. Don't let that go by you. I always talk, anytime anybody asks me, I always talk about the bright lights in the high schools. Hey, please, the bright lights in the high schools can do when you're not able to kick football or play camogie. You'll have plenty of time for that. When you're my age, you'll have plenty of as much as you want of that. But the best days in your life, you mark my words, if I, for the man above, spares me another 10 or 20 years. The best days of your life is when you're tying your football boots and going out on a Sunday or a Wednesday or whatever, going out to train 2 or 3 times a week with your teammates, your buddies, the ones that 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 you went to school with, the ones that someday, unfortunately, will all be maybe buried in the same graveyard. If you can't get on with those people, if you can't play with your own people, and if the man above has given you that body to be fit to play camogie or football or handball, why do you throw it away because of a high school or a bike light? Go for it, boys and girls. Every talks about your club. Yes, your club, I'm a Ballinasleen man through and through. I'm a Derry man through and through. Yours is Green people, Greencastle people, and yours are Tyrone people through and through. What I'm saying is, and I hear it all the time from home and from different parts, and maybe it's more familiar in Derry about being Tyrone. And I can't understand it, and I can't put up with it, and I don't accept it. This crack of club, don't go near the county, don't go near the county. If you're good enough to wear that county jersey, and let me tell you, I was lucky to wear it for 15 years for my county. And along with them years, and along with playing my blue and white for Ballinasleen, why do you not drive yourself to the top? I'm sure the people of Greencastle will be delighted if you're putting on that Tyrone jersey, because you're coming back to the club a far better player. So what I'm saying to you is, if the opportunity arises at any age level, you take it with two hands and go for it, because I'll say it again to you, you want to drive to be the best as you can be
in your sport. You want to get the best of your body on those years that you're fit to play. So what I'm saying is never turn away. Yes, you'll always be there for Greencastle, but if Tyrone comes calling, never turn your back on it. Right. Thank you. Thank you very much. I really enjoyed the night. Please God, more success around the corner. And just to finish off, I'm going to tell you, up Banniskin up there, of course. I'm going to finish off by saying two things. If no one can help me, somebody from here could divert me out this door. If I could help, I wouldn't want to get back to that seat that I was sitting on there. I'm sick, listen to that Martin man. So maybe I could get right. I mean, again, to touch seats. That might work. I belong with two good dairy men then. But anyway, up Greencastle. Good luck.
Good man, Tony. I have to say, I'll be very tempted to pull the boots on myself tomorrow morning. The problem will be I'd never be able to bend down to tie the laces. But Tony, hey, what a man. He's just absolutely a legend, a real, real legend. A hearts of Gaelic honour more dusa fe and shoh an octair, and he has special to shoh on club near Pádraig on Caistean Glas. I'm delighted and deeply honoured to have been invited along here tonight on this very, very special occasion as you reflect on the growth and success of your club and the contribution that it has made to the lives of the Greencastle community, the County of Tyrone, and to the GAA as an organisation over the course of the past 50 plus years. I am even more pleased to see the contribution being made to the club and club life by large numbers of past pupils of Our Lady of Lourdes Primary School. By lifting trophies and titles hugely important to many GAA followers, the acid test of a club staff, in my view, is the role that it plays in its own community. Greencastle GAA Club, I believe, demonstrates clearly what can be achieved when the club and the community work closely together for the good of all. So Patrick's GSC is thought of by many in Tyrone has been the perfect example of what makes a great club. That, of course, didn't happen by accident, and there have been many challenges along the way since the present club formed back in the 1969. The 70s and 80s were tough times in many ways, but in spite of the difficulties and the challenges faced, the consistency of the club's performances at youth and senior level proved that the club and the community had what it took to become a force in West Tyrone Club football. Interestingly, if you were to look back at the family names that represented the club back then, it tells its own story. And the story it tells is about the history and the topography of the area and the loyalty of the people of the community to the parish and to the club. Store names like Clark, Devon, McDermott, McCrory, Keenan, Higgy, Tade, Ward, Tracy, Fox, Conway, and McCullough all featured prominently there at the time. Those same family names are still found on many Newcastle team sheets today. And you can add to that list the likes of Coy, Bradley, Magalier, Glass, Morris, McGarvey, Donnelly, McCann, Collingwood, Toohey, McElhattan, Brogan, Warnock, McBride, Gillen, Carson, Gormley, and several others who have continued to make a huge contribution both on and off the pitch to the club and to the community. Indeed, such is the unique nature of the surnames in and around Greencastle that most Gaels in Tyrone can recognise a Greencastle team sheet purely and simply from hearing the surnames thereof. Some surnames are very much associated with certain places in Tyrone, and in Greencastle they form a vital part of the identity of the area. Identity in the GAA is hugely important, and one of the most important parts of that identity is firstly having your own facilities, and secondly making sure that they are well maintained and developed. The opening of the pitch in the new building back in 1988 was the club and its members a statement of intent. Can I just correct Tony? Gary didn't win that game that day.
Tyrone took about six players off. The reason being, Frankie Bradley told me there's going to be a shortage of starters for me, and we want to get starters in first. So took about six players off, and Derry, I think, can come with a point today. But anyway, Greencastle was always a tough place to visit for any away team, and money's at 2 points for one just by the location of a pitch itself. In terms of resources, the club has come a long way since then, and its present facilities are the envy of many the left and breadth of the country. They are a testament to the unique relationship that exists between the club and the community that it serves. And that, of course, is most clearly evident during the adventure to Greencastle on St. Stephen's Day for the end of the run. You see, club members are working together and all came together just to make sure this prestigious event takes place each year. Tells you all you need to know about the strength of the community and the allegiance of its members. Of course, so many people involved in the GAA, winning titles is all that matters. Greencastle's record through the 70s maybe wasn't great, but with some great grief coming through the time, the first title arrived in 1992. In fact, then there was no talk of Ulster or Ireland club titles, but the winning of that championship was celebrated with an All-Ireland victory, as the hunger of the club and its members was finally saved. Several titles have come and gone since then, including Club All-Ireland to both men's and women's football. A unique achievement for any club of their own, and testament to the old Irish saying, one and over of his chubby. I was fortunate enough to work in the parish at the time, and to see and experience the sense of joy and pride that brought at the time was absolutely fantastic. It's impossible to quantify the pride and sense of identity that people have for their own parish and their club, but it's something that is deeply rooted in the Irish saying, and the GAA plays a huge role in that. Nowhere illustrates that better, in my view, than the Greencastle Club in the community. A number of people over the past 6 decades have taken great pride in representing their families and their clubs on the field of play in Camogie and Hurling, and Gaelic football is hugely impressive. Everybody who wanted to compete was given a chance or found a niche. The club and its facilities are the centre of the parish life and are much more than just a meeting place for the youth of the parish. They're basically a venue for everything that goes on. Many of those same young people competed proudly in the handball alleys or broken halls up and down the county, a score representing St. Patrick's, Sparrow, or Fallacies. The opportunities provided through these competitions helped them become the fine young people we see today among us. Fortunately for the club, they developed that sense of giving back to the community that is vital for any GAA club to succeed and to thrive. Now, next up is this. It would be remiss of me not to mention that many Gaelics in the Greencastle area who have travelled abroad during the past 60 years, settled overseas either on a temporary basis or permanently. The contribution that they could have made to the life of the club back home will never be known. However, such is the spirit of the Greencastle Gael and the local culture and games that exist within them, that even though they are sometimes thousands of miles from home, many of those same elements continue to make significant contributions to the growth and development of the GAA across the world, and particularly in their new places of residence. I'm often asked by people from abroad and from other cultures and communities at times to define what the GAA means to its members, what it is and what it means to its members. My answer is very simple, because I use places like Greencastle and Galway as examples of what the GAA means in rural areas. I can show people the fantastic facilities that the club currently has, tell them something of the history of the place, the humble beginnings, and the work put out on a voluntary basis by the men and women of the area, whose love for Gaelic games and Irish culture ensured that the establishing of the GAA Club of Greencastle would become such a success. The community, this community and the club it serves is the physical embodiment of what Michael Cusick and his colleagues envisioned when they met in Hayes Hotel in Fergus in 1884. The founding fathers of the GAA sought to stir the national conscience and not only preserve Irish culture and games, but to have it played and promoted in every parish and village across Ireland. It took quite a while for the ideas and aspirations of the founding fathers to spread across the country, and there were many obstacles along the way. Population decline, civil unrest, lack of finance, unsuitable location, obtaining land, emigration and war. And just some of the reasons the club struggled with one status. People of Greencastle cannot place fully with all of these and more. It takes serious resolve and commitment to overcome such difficulties and setbacks, and to continue to hope, to aspire, and ultimately to succeed. Fortunately for Newcastle, the right people at the right place at the right time, and just over half a century ago, the current club was established. The club has come a long way since those first tentative steps, and its achievements are well known and acknowledged across the country and beyond. Every aspect of Gaelic games and Irish culture is positively promoted and fully appreciated, and those volunteers who give up their time selflessly week after week deserve great credit for the selfless work they continue to do. Unfortunately, the passage of time has meant that some of those involved in the formation of the club have now passed on to their eternal rewards. But by the way, to honour them and to continue the great work they started and challenge the next generation of the community to take up the baton in order to ensure the continued growth, development and success of Newcastle GAA Club. The aspirations of those who founded the club back then, perhaps they didn't envision all that the club was to come to. The names at the time may now be judged to be modest enough in hindsight, but what they did 60 years ago was light a fire, and that fire has continued to burn and produce results far in excess of what could have been hoped for back then. A lot has changed since then in terms of work, education, communication, leisure, etc. But with the physical resources now available to the players, there's no reason why this club should not continue to go a strong state from step to step. Took over 20 years for the first championship, you're right, and a lot has been achieved with this great club since that. With the talent that is currently available and the youth that is coming through, I look forward to seeing what the next 20 years may bring, and, God willing, coming back to celebrate the arrival of the first senior county title for the club. Before I finish, can I once again thank the club for inviting me along tonight. It really has been an honour and a privilege, and with love at the table and education. And I wish the club and the community continued success at all levels. And as Sean Tay would often say, come on the castle. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Grand Father, I think you all agree both Noel and Tony have been absolutely fantastic tonight. And as a token of appreciation, Michael Coyne is going to present both Tony and Noel for something for us. At this stage, ladies and gentlemen, we're almost ready to start the music, but just beforehand, could I invite Martin Brogan up to the front to start our auction, please? Could we also get Emmett Bradley to come up and help with the display, please?
Afraid of a fuck. I'm afraid it wasn't here enough, is it? So I want to get up here, Peter Noel, because I know he's going to be batting. And I need to see a lot of you. I know Greencastle was very successful at football, but they've also a lot of very successful businessmen. So I don't think they'll, I hope they'll make my job very easy tonight. The first thing we see is a photograph of the two All-Ireland winning teams. So, would you start me off, who's going to be £100? That 100, and a 100, and 120, and 120, 150, 150, and 150, and 150, every minute 150, and 150, every minute 150. Anybody else? 160, 160, and 160, and 160, and 160, and 160, and 160. Anybody else there at 160? Wave. 170, 170, minute 170, and 170, 180, 180, 200, at 200, only minute 200. Anybody else there at 200? My wasn't anybody. Wag, if you 200 thousand, at 200, at 200, only minute at 200, 200, at 200 thousand. I'm going to sell it now. Last call. Anybody else there at 200? 220, 220, 220. You're out today at 220. At 220, at 220, only win, at 220. Anybody else there at 220? Anybody else? This is the last chance there, at 220, at 220. 250, 250, at 250, 250, 280, at 280, at 280, only win at 280. Anybody else there at 280? I don't want to ask you. 280, come on. Oh, you're 280. I thought it was going to go to the top road, at 280, at 280. 300, at 300, at 300, at 300, anybody else now? At 300, at 300, I must not anybody at 300, I'm selling them now, 300, at 300, I'm selling them at 300, Donnelly's, I think it's Donnelly's, isn't it? This is a signed Spare No 2019 jersey. Who's going to start me for that? Give me 100. Somebody give me 100. 100 bid. At 100, only bid at 100. 120, 120, 120, at 120. Anybody else there at 120? At 120. It'll be put in the frame now. Whatever type of frame you want. At 120. At 120, only bid at 120. Anybody else there? At 120. Are you bidding? 140. At 140. 140. At 140. At 140. At 140. At 140. Anybody else there? At 140. At 140. My bidder's down here now. At 140. At 140. At 140. At 140. Only at 140. I'm selling them out last time. Anybody else there? At 140. Anybody? I must go or it'll happen. This is the same thing, men's jersey, 2019. Stand on there, 140. Stand on, anybody give me 140 for it? Surely 140 for the men's jersey. Bid at 140. At 140, 5. 300. At 200, anybody at 200. At 200, anybody else at 200? At 200. At 200. That's all you think of the men now at 200. At 200. Is anybody else at 200? At 200. Give me anybody else. 250. At 250. At 250. What about you, Fox? At 250. What about Johnny? Oh, at 250. At 250. At 250. You only been at 250. 370. 370. 300. At 300. Only been at 300 for the men's jersey. At 300. At 300. Only been at 300. Anybody else now? 300. 350, 350, 400, at 400, 400, at 400, only minute 400. Anybody else at 400? Am I missing this? 500, at 500, at 500, at 500, 520, at 520, at 520, 550, at 550, at 550, only minute 550. Anybody else now? 550, 600, at 600, back. At 600, at 600 for the man's jersey now. At 600. Colly, I'm waiting on you now. What about Dean Fox? At 620, at 620, at 620. Anybody else? What about Mickey Jordan? At 620. Where are you? Anyway, I can't see you. At 620. I have the man here at 620. 650, that's 650. 700, that's 700. That's 700, only that's 700. I'm selling them. Is everybody out and happy? That's 700. 720. That's 720. That's 720. That's 720. You're all out now. That's 720. Everybody satisfied? That's 720. 720. 750. That's 750. That's 750. That's 750. I always told you there was money in Greencastle. That's 750. 800. At 800. At 800. Only about 800. I'm selling now. Do you see themselves? That's 800. At 800. That's it. Garden or Mark on.
Ladies and gentlemen, our last piece is a very, very special piece to the club. As you'll see, it's an engraved piece of wood with the outline of all the townlands of Greencastle on it, both inscribed in English and Irish, with all the meanings of each townland also engraved.
This will be a great plaque for all, some of all you business people here. A lovely plaque. A lovely, lovely bit of them. 200. Two bid. At 200, only bid at 200. At two bid. At 200. At two. At two for the plaque. At 200. 300. At 300. At three bid at 300, only bid at 300. At 300. At 300. At 300. Anybody else? At 300. At 300, only bid at 300. Anybody else? 350. At 350. 350. At 350, only about 50 to the flat. At 350. At 350. At 350. Right. 350. At 350. There's that button over there. Button over there. Dangerous. At 350. At 350, only about 350. Anybody else? 400. At 400. At 400, only about here on my right. At 400. At 400 pounds. At 400. At 400. At 400 pound. I'm going to sell it now. At 400. Anybody else now? Last time. 450. At 450. 500. At 500. At 500. Only been at 500. I'm selling now. At 500. At 500. Anybody else? At 500. I'm sorry. At 500 pound. Last. 550. 550. I knew there was somebody else there. At 550. Back to you again, at 550. At 550, back to you. 550, at 550. Anybody else? At 550. 600, at 600. At 600, we'll do it at 600. I've given you all plenty of time, and 600 pounds. 650, at 650. 700, at 700. At 700 at the back. At 700. Any 750, at 750. At 750, 750. Shout if I'm Mr. Neal. At 750. At 750. At 750. Oh, anybody else? He's all finished over here now. At 750. I'm selling Noel Conley. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very, very much for your generosity in the auction, and also a big thanks to Martin Brogan for helping us with that auction. Just before we start into the dancing, ladies and gentlemen, our chairman Michael Coy would like to say a few words.
Folks, I'm not going to say very much other than to wish us all the best for the rest of the night. There's going to be a gas clipping around there, so I want everybody to put their name in the gas clipping if they recall any special memory of their times in Greencastle or any game or whatever. Please put it in that book so we'll keep it as memory going forward. And also here, this is one of those keeping up with things here. We have an Instagram frame, so you can get your photograph taken on that. And that's really all I want to say, folks. Enjoy the rest of the night.
Thank you. Thank you. Some say the real sun is light.